We're on our way to a place few outsiders ever travel, where some of the most unique people on Earth have made their home. An island in the middle of Tanzania's mighty Lake Victoria.
In Africa, people, they believe much on superstition.
I'm traveling with filmmaker and activist Harry Freeland to meet the ghost people of Ukerewe.
This island surrounded by water and was 4 hours from the mainland, this community that informed this society to look out for each other.
I was called maybe a white god or a devil. Sometimes other people, they were like, oh, my goodness, this person is ghost. Then I was asking my mother, Mom, tell me the truth. Am I ghost?
Joseph Atona is one of Tanzania's ghost people, striking albinos cursed by a gene mutation traced to a single ancestor 2,500 years ago.
I asked my mother, why am I different? Why if I go to the sun, I get burned? Of course, the answer to her was, it's the will of God. The way how you are is the will of God. I didn't know if the will of God, why am I different? Why others are black?
While they proclaim albinos are dangerous alive, bizarrely they say, dead, they can bring great fortune.
People started to hunt us like wild animals, and they started to chop our body parts in different ways because of believing if you get the body parts of people with albinism, you'll become rich.
Many people with albinism have simply disappeared. Other attacks and murders haven't been reported. The ones who have survived the attacks have been left mutilated.
Say a femur from a person with albinism could go for $1,000 or more. So to say that one particular genetic difference is worth murdering a human being is obscene.
With a price on their heads, the albinos have been forced to take refuge in remote areas, away from the poachers.
Aya.
It looks like a happy, functioning primary school. But the words the children are singing tell the true story of why they are here. And the razor wire and bars, a stark physical reality of the risk they face. But sadly, even here, they're not truly safe.
There are high walls around this place covered in barbed wire. It's meant to be for their own protection, but it's incredibly sad. And the whole issue here in Tanzania is very, very sensitive. Sunday night was only allowed to come here on the condition that we had a government advisor with us at all times, night and day. And the only reason I can tell you this is because for the first time in our shoot, he's just stepped away.
Some of these camps have 300 children with albinism. They're surrounded by high walls, guarded by police at night. Some of them severely traumatized.
But the albinos, led by Josephat, are fighting back. He's become an outspoken campaigner for his hunted people.
So this is what you built?
Yeah, this is the building that will provide sort of training for people with albinism on Ukerewe.
Harry Freeland has launched a charity and built a community center where albinos can learn and work in safety.
And what's the ultimate goal?
The ultimate goal is to create more jobs and break down the barriers of discrimination. And we're seeing that those barriers being broken down already. You know, real acceptance is taking place. And here we're gonna have sewing machines.
A sign of how life is changing is this young man, Vedastus, who was living in destitute conditions when Harry first filmed him. He was an outcast. This is Vedastus today, standing out in a crowd and among Harry's proud workforce.
When I first met Vedastus in 2006, he was a 14-year-old boy. He was rejected by his father when he was born, was kicked out of school. And today is a boy who's graduated, who now speaks a bit of English, who's just met a girlfriend. All his dreams he had when he was young are coming true and start, and life's really, really changing for him.
Brilliant.
Yeah, very proud of him. So over the next 3 years, they're providing 4,200 vision devices for children with albinism.
Albinos have extremely sensitive eyes, and many have poor eyesight. Harry's charity is providing prescription glasses to thousands of schoolchildren. The aim is ensuring a better education and a more certain future.
That's nice.
Yeah, this is perfect.
Yeah?
Sure.
Yeah, can you show me?
The visual impairment of a person with albinism is one of the biggest barriers in the classroom for a child with albinism. Getting vision care is a vital thing. It's something they've never received in Tanzania before. So we provide prescription glasses, monocular telescopes so they can see the blackboard, sunglasses, magnifiers to help them read and make the writing bigger in their textbooks.
Can you focus on something far away?
Oh, my
focus
goodness.
Focus on those lines. How is it?
Yeah, it's bringing closer.
It's bringing it closer, yeah.
Closer.
So imagine if you had this when you were young in the classroom, being able to see the little details when they're writing.
I wish if I could get this before.
Yeah, sure.
We all, I think, everyone here knows about the suffering that people with albinism had faced in Tanzania.
The struggle is far from over, but the campaign, led by Josephat, is making the future brighter than ever.
I don't think he ever will stop. No, he's tireless. There's a line he says that one day we'll all sit around the same table. I think that's the thing he's always thinking about, and that's his kind of thing that keeps him going, that one day they'll be accepted.
When is that day?
I think it's coming, and I hope he'll witness it in his lifetime. Certainly in Vedastus's, I'm sure we'll get there.